Okay, so we are going to discuss the last topic of chapter 1. So we learn we get a general solution for a differential equation when we have infinitely many solutions. Just like we have for this differential equation, the general solution is y square plus x square is equal to c. C is an arbitrary constant. So we have infinitely many solutions because you can pick any value for c. And this is a, is this an explicit or implicit solution? This is a implicit solution, right? Because y is not the subject. You cannot explicitly say what is a, y. Okay, now we learn that we call these type of solutions a family of solutions because you get a whole bunch of solutions for different c values. And we say we have a parameter. So the parameter is actually c, unknown parameter. This particular solution, here we say a one parameter solution because we have one c that we don't know really. If we know a condition, well, we know that what is that c, right? But here this is a differential solution for a differential equation with a one unknown c, a constant, arbitrary constant. So it's a one parameter solution. So usually a first order differential equation have a one unknown parameter, arbitrary constant. A second order differential equation will have two parameters. So that will be a two parameter solution. And then the general solution for a third order differential equation will be, will like have three parameters, C1, C2, C3, or A, B, C. So nth order differential equation will have n parameters in the general solution. Okay. Now then again, it raises up another question. Do we have solution that is parameter free? Well, we do have solutions. So those type of solutions, we call them particular solutions. The particular specific solution where you do not have infinitely many copies, that's the solution, that's the specific one, not dependent on any arbitrary constants or parameters, that is a particular solution. So now let's do one of the exercises regarding parameter solutions. Okay, so here we have a second order differential equation and we have a two parameter solution. Y is equal to C1 cosine t plus C2 sine t. Now, how many solutions we have here? Infinitely many, right? You can choose any number for C1 and C2 because they are just arbitrary constant. Let's say they have given us a condition. So initial value problems, here this is a second order differential equation, so we have two conditions. So y0 is negative 1 and y'0 is 7. So you can see you have conditions up to one derivative less, so until the first derivative, and at the same x value 0. So this is an initial value problem. Now, when you have an initial condition, you can exactly find what is this unknown parameters are, C1 and C2. Well, let's learn how to do that, okay? So what you do is actually use condition, use these conditions one by one. So let's use the first condition. When x is equal to 0, y is negative 1. So we read this as when x is equal to 0, y is negative 1, okay? What is inside the bracket is the x value. So what we do is we substitute that into the solution. So y is negative 1 when C1 cosine 0 plus C2 sine 0. Okay, I think the independent variable is t. So when t is equal to 0, y is negative 1. So cosine 0 is 1, sine 0 is 0, right? So C2 times 0 is 0. So C1 times 1 is 1. So C1 is actually negative 1. Okay, all right. Then we found the one unknown parameter. Then let's use the second condition. y'0 is 7. Now it is not straightforward to use the second condition because second condition is for first derivative of y. So y is actually c1 cosine t plus c2 sine t. So we have to differentiate this one time to use this condition. So y' will be like, if you differentiate with respect to t, cosine t derivative is negative sine. So c1 sine t plus derivative of sine is cosine c2 cosine t. So that's y prime. Now if you substitute t is equal to 0, you get 7 for y prime. So 7 is equal to negative c1 sine 0 is 0 plus c2 cosine 0 is 1. So this is 0. So c2 is actually 7. So then we can write the unique solution as c1 is negative 1 cosine t plus c2 is 7. So 7 sine t. So out of the two parameter general solution, we get the unique solution when we use the initial conditions. Okay. All right. So let's look at another challenging example. So we have the same differential equation here. Okay. But we have different conditions. So let's write the general solution again. Y is equal to C1 cosine T plus C2 sine T. The initial conditions are Y pi 4 is equal to 0. And y prime pi 4 is equal to root 2. Okay, let's see this. Now here, let's use the first condition. So when t is pi over 4, y is 0. Y is 0, c1 cosine pi over 4 plus c2 sine pi over 4. So now, cosine pi over 4 is root 2 over 2. So this is root 2 c1 over 2 plus sine pi over 4 is root 2 over 2. So root 2 c2 over 2. So let's multiply this equation by 2. So we get 0 root 2 c1 plus root 2 c2. Well, we didn't able to get c1 nor c2 just like in the first problem, right? But it's okay. Let's have it like first equation, because we have two conditions. So to use the second condition, we have to find the derivative, but y prime is actually, we found that negative c1 sine t plus c2 cosine t, right? We found it in the first equation. Now let's use the second condition. So y prime should be root 2 when t is pi over 4, sine pi over 4 plus c2 cosine pi over 4. So here root 2 is sine pi over 4 is root 2 over 2. Here root 2 over 2 is cosine pi over 4. So let's multiply the whole equation by 2. So it's 2 root 2 is negative root 2 c1 plus root 2 c2. So we get two equations, but none of the times we were not able to solve for c1 or c2, right? So we have a problem, a situation. Now, let's write this equation in an aligned version. So, 2 root 2 is equal to negative root 2 c1 plus root 2 c2. We have two simultaneous equations, right? So, we have two equations and two unknowns, c1 and c2. So, we should be able to find c1 and c2. Let's do a magic. Let's add the first equation to the second equation. Because if we add the left-hand side, it's 0 plus 2 root 2. If you add the right hand side, it's root 2 c1 plus root 2 c2 minus root 2 c1 plus root 2 c2, right? So you can see why I add the first equation and the second equation, because I can cancel out the c1 term whole, okay? See, it is the same coefficient for c1 but opposite sign. So we were able to cancel them when we add the equations. So 2 root 2 on the left is equal to root 2 c2. Root 2 c2 is 2 root 2 c2. So if you divide by 2 root 2, c2 is actually 1. Do you see that? So we were still able to find c2 from using these two equations. Now c2 is 1. Let's use one of these first equation. So 0 is root 2 c1. Now c2 is 1. So 1 times root 2 is root 2. So now if we solve for c1, let's take the root 2 to the left. So it's negative root 2 is equal to root 2 c1. Now if you divide by root 2 both sides, c1 is negative 1. Good. So we were able to find c2. Then we were able to find c1 using c2. So the general solution is now c1 times cosine t plus c2 times sine t. So c1 is negative 1 times cosine t is negative cosine t plus 1 times c2 is sine t. So this is the unique solution for the initial conditions, for the new initial conditions. For from the general solution, we use the initial condition, we got the unique solution. Okay. All right, so that's the end of section 1.1 and 1.2. Thank you.